So, in this module, we will learn about the various network components, that is the physical media and the interconnecting devices. The physical media includes the coaxial cables, optical fibers, twisted turn cables, etc., while the interconnecting devices include hubs, switches, and routers. We will talk about the level of intelligence they use and how they actually function.
Networking, the physical layer. Networking layers. Here first is the physical layer, then comes the link layer, then is the network layer, transport layer, and finally here comes the application layer. The transmission medium can be broadly defined as anything that can carry information from a source to a destination. So here the transmission mediums play a very important role in carrying the information from the sender to the receiver. For example, the transmission medium for two people having a dinner conversation is the air. And for a written message, the transmission medium might be a mail carrier, a truck, or an aeroplane. So in data communication, transmission medium is usually a free space, a metallic cable, or a fiber optic cable. In telecommunication, the transmission media can be divided into two broad categories, the guided and the unguided. Guided media includes the twisted pair cable, the coaxial cable, and the fiber optic cable. And the unguided media, which is the wireless one, includes the free space. A twisted pair consists of two conductors, each with its own plastic insulation twisted together. One of the wire is used to carry the signal to the receiver and the other is used only as a ground reference. So the receiver uses the difference between the two. In addition of sending the signals, sometimes what comes as an unwanted signal are the interference. So if the two wires are in parallel, the effect of these unwanted signal is not seen in both wires because they are at different locations, and this may result in difference at the receiver end. So it can be maintained by twisting the pairs. A balance is maintained between them. Now suppose if one wire is close to the noise source, then the other one comes next close to the noise source. So twisting make it probable that both wires are equally affected by external influences like noise. This means that the receiver, which calculates the difference between the two, receives no unwanted signal. And so unwanted signals are almost removed out. There are two types of twisted pair cable. One is unshielded twisted pair cable, which is known as UTP, and the other one is the shielded twisted pair cable, STP. In unshielded twisted pair cables, this is the most used one in the communication, and the other one is the STP, which has a metal foil covering these pairs of insulated conductors. And though this metal casing improves the quality of cable by preventing the penetration of noise, but it is more bulkier and more expensive. The most commonly used UTP connector is the RJ45 jack, that is the registered jack. It has a female connector and a male connector, and the female connector gets male connector into it. The twisted pair cables are used in telephone lines to provide voice and data channel. Now comes the coaxial cable. This coaxial cable carries a signal of higher frequency ranges than those in the twisted pair cable. Here we have a central core conductor of solid which is enclosed in an insulating sheath, which is in turn encased in an outer conductor of metallic foil, and whole of these is covered by a plastic insulator. coaxial cables are categorized by their radio government ratings, that is the RJ ratings. Each RJ number denotes a unique set of physical specifications, which includes like the wire gauge of the inner conductor, thickness, etc. And each cable defined by an RJ rating is adapted for specialized functions, as shown in the table. To connect the coaxial cables to devices, we need coaxial connectors, and the most common connector used today is the Bayonne-Neel concealment connector, that is the BNC connector. And this figure shows the BNC connector here, and it is used to connect the end of the cable to a device such as TV sets. The cable TV uses RJ59 coaxial cables, and these coaxial cables are even used in the Ethernet LAN because of its high bandwidth and so consequently high data rate. Coaxial cables was chosen for digital transmission. A fiber optic cable is made of glass or plastic and transmits signals in form of light. The glass or plastic core is surrounded by a cladding which is less denser than this core. And the difference between the density of this core and cladding makes the light beam moving through the core reflect off when it touches the cladding instead of being refracted from that cladding portion. There are two types of optical fiber. The first one is the multimode. In multimode, multiple beams of light move through the core in different paths, and the diameter is much bigger than the wavelength of the transmitted light. In multimode step index fiber, the density of the core remains constant from the center to the edge, and as beam of light moves through this constant density in a straight line until it reaches the interference of core and the cladding, and at the interference there is an abrupt change in the density which alters the angle of the beam's motion, and because of this sudden change, it contributes to the distortion of the signal as it passes through the fiber. The second type of fiber is multimode graded index fiber, which decreases this distortion of the signal through the cable. In the graded index fiber, there is a varying density. Density is highest at the center of the core, and which decreases gradually to its lowest at the edge. The fiber optic cable has several advantages over metallic cable, that is the twisted pair cable and the coaxial cable. It has higher bandwidth than those two wires, and currently data rate and bandwidth utilization over fiber optic cable are limited not by the medium but by the signal generation and reception technology available. Secondly, it has less signal attenuation. Fiber optic transmission distance is significantly greater than those of the guided media, other guided media. The signal can run for 50 km without requiring any regeneration. And whereas we need repeaters every 5 km for coaxial or twisted pair cables. Immunity to the electromagnetic interference. Electromagnetic noise cannot affect these fiber optic cables. The fiber optic cables are much lighter than the copper cables, but it also have some disadvantages. Fiber optic cable is a relatively new technology, and its installation and maintenance require expertise that is not yet available everywhere. The cable and the interferences are relatively more expensive than those of the other guided media. As the propagation of light is unidirectional, so if we need bidirectional communication, then we need two fibers in that case. Division. What is the significance of twisting the twisted pair cables? Actually, by twisting the wires, the noise equally affects both the wires, so when receivers receives the information, he can calculate the differences between the two, and so the noise can be removed totally from that. What are the advantages of optical fiber on twisted pair cables and coaxial cables? The optical fiber cable has higher bandwidth, less signal attenuation, immunity to electromagnetic interferences, resistance to corrosive materials, and even lightweight.